There are many ways to observe wildlife on one of New Hampshire Fish and Game's many wildlife management areas. Sight and sound are the two that we think of most often, but there's a lot to be learned about wildlife from the clues that they leave behind for us. I'm here today at the Robert Durant WMA to talk a little bit about finding and locating tracks and signs from wildlife and what that can tell us about the individuals who call our wildlife management areas home. Wildlife require food, water, and cover to survive in their natural habitats. I find that water resources tend to be the best for locating tracks as it creates mud and sand where the animal's depression can remain for a few days. So let's see if we can find some water here on the Durant WMA and see if we can locate some tracks. Wildlife uses water for drinking, finding food, and for traveling about the landscape, as streams and rivers often take the path of least resistance and have lush, thick vegetation on the sides of them that provides cover while the animals move.
With that in mind, riverbanks and the edges of the river can be a great spot for locating tracks.
In order to increase our odds of finding animal tracks, we want to look for unique features along our waterway that's going to concentrate animals. For example, here, we have a major tributary that's being met into a large river. Right here where the water turns, we can see mud and silt that's settled. This looks like a great place to start our search for some animal tracks. Look at this, our first track of the day. We've got a beautiful mink track here. You can see where it hunted along the river. Be sure to look very closely as you scan the riverbank. Some of these tracks can be very small and hard to detect, like these sandpiper tracks that we see skittering along the riverbank. Tracking wildlife can include looking for more than just footprints. Here we see a fresh feed stick from a beaver. Just up on shore above it, we have a fresh castor mound, still wet from last night when it was placed here. And lastly, we see a fresh chewing from a beaver. These are all signs that can tell us about what animal are passing through the area with more than just footprints. Now that we know a little bit more about where wildlife likes to travel and some good characteristics for tracking sand and mud, let's head upstream and see if there's any other species that pass through here in the night.
How cool is this? Along the riverbank, you find the track of a porcupine. You don't usually think of these guys as being riparian critters, but
you never know what you're going to find along the riverbank.
This track here is a few days old based on the fact that it's been rained on, but we can still see the distinct characteristics of a deer's track.
Today on our short walk, we were able to locate the tracks of mink, porcupine, white-tailed deer, and found a lot of activity of active beavers up and down this river, just from knowing where to look and what specific conditions to look for on the edges of the river. New Hampshire Fish and Game manages 60,000 acres of wildlife management areas where you can learn to track wildlife and hone your tracking skills. For more information on where you can find a wildlife management area or to get your very own New Hampshire Fish and Game track identification card to help while you learn your skills, visit wildnh.com.